Incredible. One more big impact on Jupiter. In mid-September, another asteroid plunged into the thick atmosphere of the giant of the solar system, disintegrating in a flash of light. Since 1994, the year of the first incredible collision, that of the comet Shoemaker-Levy 9, this is the eighth event that testifies to the ability of Jupiter to attract comets and small asteroids. It's a phenomenon that's increasingly captured thanks to improved technology. It's September 13th. In Brazil, the sun has just set. For many astronomy enthusiasts, it's the beginning of an observing night like many others. Jupiter is on the eastern horizon, about 25 degrees high. José Luis Pereira, an astrophotographer from São Caetano do Sul, just north of São Paulo, begins to capture the planet in high resolution with his 275mm diameter reflector telescope, as he has been doing since 2004 when he began a methodical monitoring activity of the gas giant. The evening offers the meridian passage of the Great Red Spot, but the view isn't consistent. After a few good images, the conditions worsen and the shots become muddy and poor in detail, so that the temptation comes to disassemble everything and go to bed waiting for a better night. So the acquisition of footage is interrupted and the mouse moves the cursor to the button that would turn off the computer. But for some reason, José hesitates, and it is by chance, intuition, or simple dedication, he decides not to click, but to give himself another half hour of waiting. Luck is on his side, and the weather conditions miraculously begin to improve, and after a while, new shots begin. The red spot is now close to the trailing end, making the planet less spectacular, but he has patience. This is when it happens. To his great surprise, during the filming of the first video, he noticed a bright dot lighting upon the planet's disk, but he didn't pay much attention to it, partially because he was pressured by the weather conditions that were starting to deteriorate again, and partly because he thought it might be some kind of artifact linked to the recording parameters adopted. Then he closes everything and entrusts the analysis of the footage to software called Detect, an open source for astronomy that checks each frame of the film and identifies any light anomalies, distinguishing them from artifacts due to the acquisition or electronics of the instrumentation. The software will take hours to do its job, and so José launches the program and goes to sleep. The next morning, when he wakes up, José almost doesn't remember what happened, but it is a screen of the program that makes him remember. An alert is trying to attract his attention on a flashing text that says, "Probable detection of an impact on Jupiter, frames 122 to 153. Very excited, José launches an alert via the internet so that other observers can confirm the discovery. The news bounced all over the world and thousands of visitors crashed his site, forcing him to deactivate it. But it was also the beginning of success that would be confirmed shortly after by the official confirmation. Other observers, in fact, rushed to check if the bright spot appeared in their footage of the same night, and other footage emerged where the impact was clearly visible. In short, José can rest assured. It is not a spurious signal. Once again, Jupiter was definitely hit by an object of cosmic nature. An asteroid? A comet? This is not known. To know it, we should be able to observe the shape and distribution of the scars of the impact, or the dark spots that form in the agitated Jovian atmosphere as a result of the pulverization of the object. Residues at the moment have not been found, which suggests that the impactor body, probably a small asteroid, should not be very large, at most about 50 meters in diameter. At the moment, therefore, the community of amateur astronomers is committed not only to view images and videos of those moments to find traces of the glow, but is also invited to search for signs left by the alleged impact, which may have appeared or appear in these nights, to confirm the nature of the glow. Hang on a sec. What's with all the excitement over a pebble slamming into Jupiter? Well, it all probably has to do with the fact that the discovery of these events is almost all thanks to the observational network formed by a few thousand enthusiastic amateur astronomers. Then there are important issues involved, such as estimates of the frequency of impacts in the inner solar system, which of course affects the estimate of the risk to our planet in this regard. When estimating the probability of an asteroid impacting the Earth, one must not only consider the mere geometric cross-section of the planet, but also the gravitational cross-section. In the case of planet Jupiter, the gravitational field is very intense, due to its mass being 317 times that of Earth. Consequently, its gravitational cross-section is much larger than that of Earth. For this reason, Jupiter is hit much more often than our planet, and collisions occur at a minimum speed of 60 kilometers per second, the escape velocity of Jupiter. In addition to the mass factor, the relative proximity to the inner solar system allows Jupiter to influence the distribution of minor bodies. For a long time, it was believed that these characteristics led to the gas giant to eject from the system or to attract most of the stray objects in its vicinity and consequently to determine a reduction in the number of potentially dangerous objects for Earth. Subsequent dynamical studies have shown that, in reality, Jupiter's function as an inner solar system shield has often been overestimated. The situation is, in fact, much more complex. The presence of Jupiter, in fact, tends to reduce the frequency of impact on Earth of objects coming from the Oort cloud, long-period comets, while it increases in the case of asteroids and short-period comets, which are deflected towards Earth's orbit. Hang on a sec, guys, before we continue. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell, you will help us to make products of even higher quality. For this reason, Jupiter is the planet in the solar system characterized by the highest frequency of impacts, which justifies its name of sweeper or cosmic vacuum cleaner of the solar system. Studies of 2009 suggest a frequency of one impact every 50 to 350 years for an object of 0.5 to 1 kilometer in diameter. Impacts with smaller objects would occur with greater frequency, as it is natural and as evidenced by the chronology of events that we are about to tell you. 1994 was a memorable year for planetary astronomy. For the first time, in fact, when comet Shoemaker-Levy 9 was captured by Jupiter and dismembered in at least 21 fragments that fell on the planet starting from July 16th of that year, it was possible to witness live the collision between two celestial bodies. Unfortunately, the geometry of the collision was not conducive to direct observations from Earth, and impacts could be observed only by the Galileo probe. The only thing left for us Earthlings to do was to follow the evolution of the scars left in the gaseous atmosphere of the planet, with perturbations so evident and contrasted that even very modest optical instruments allowed the observation. It seemed an exceptional case, so that to find something similar we had to go back to December 1690, when Gian Domenico Cassini left to posterity a drawing of Jupiter's disk on which appeared spots very similar to those left by the impacts of July of 1994. And this belief on the rarity of these events lasted in practice up into current times. Discovered on March 25, 1993 by astronomers Eugene and Carolyn Shoemaker and by amateur David Levy examining some photographic plates of Jupiter's surroundings, the comet immediately aroused the interest of the scientific community. It had never happened that a comet was discovered orbiting a planet and not directly around the Sun. Captured by Jupiter presumably between the second half of the 60s and the early 70s, it traveled in 2 years of very long orbit, which took it from a minimum distance of 35,000 kilometers from Jupiter to a maximum of 25 million kilometers. The comet made several transits near the gas giant, during which it suffered the intense tidal forces responsible for the final fragmentation of a nucleus of at least 2 kilometers in diameter. In 1993, Shoemaker-Levy 9 appeared as a long line of bright dots bathed in the luminescence of their tails and on a collision course with Jupiter. The studies conducted on the orbit of the comet shortly after its discovery led to the conclusion that it would fall on the planet by July of 1994. That started an extensive observational campaign that involved many instruments for the recording of the event. Among these, the Hubble Space Telescope, the ROSAT satellite, and the Galileo probe, which was en route for a rendezvous with the planet planned for 1995. The impacts occurred on the side of the planet opposite the Earth, but the Galileo probe was able to observe them directly from a distance of 240 million kilometers. The rapid rotation of Jupiter then made observable from Earth the signs of the entry of individual fragments in the upper atmosphere of the planet. The first impact occurred at 2013 Universal Time on July 16, 1994, when fragment A of the nucleus hit the southern hemisphere of the planet at a speed of 60 kilometers per second. The instruments on board of Galileo probe detected a fireball that reached the temperature of 24,000 degrees Celsius. Over the next 6 days, 21 distinct impacts were observed, with the largest coming on July 18th at 7:33 Universal Time when fragment G struck Jupiter. This impact created a giant dark spot over 12,000 kilometers across and was estimated to have released an energy equivalent to 6 million megatons of TNT, 600 times the world's nuclear arsenal. Two impacts, 12 hours apart on July 19th, created impact marks of similar size to that caused by fragment G, and impacts continued until July 22nd, when fragment W struck the planet. So great was the disruption caused in the Jovian atmosphere that the scars of the event remained observable from Earth for several months. The direct observation of impact events on Jupiter has led to the growing awareness, even in public opinion, that the impact of a comet or asteroid on our planet would have potentially devastating consequences. The general public was very impressed by the event, and the media devoted a great deal of attention to Shoemaker-Levy 9. The role played by non-professional astronomers in identifying the signs of impact is also significant, thanks to a reduction in the cost of advanced observation instruments. In 2009 to 2010, in fact, other impacts were recorded, the first on July 19, 2009, just 15 years after that of Shoemaker-Levy 9, when Australian Anthony Wesley noticed from his observatory in New Wales a conspicuous dark spot that lasted for several days, probably the residue from the impact of a small asteroid. The second occurred a year later on June 3, 2010, when Wesley and Christopher Goh independently photographed a small flash in the southern equatorial band. The light emission lasted only a couple of seconds and did not leave obvious signs in the atmosphere, so that the impact was interpreted as that of an object of only 8 to 13 meters in diameter. The third was even less obvious and was recorded on August 20th of the same year by Japanese amateur Masayuki Takikawa in the northern equatorial band. On September 10, 2012, at 11:35 Universal Time, amateur astronomer Dan Peterson detected from Racine, Wisconsin, a fireball on Jupiter that lasted 1 or 2 seconds. The fireball was created by a meteoroid less than 10 meters in diameter, quite similar to the flash observed on August 20, 2010. On March 17, 2016, an impact fireball observed on Jupiter was recorded by Gerrit Kernbauer in Austria. This report was later confirmed by an independent observation by amateur John McKeon. The size of the impact object was estimated to be between 7 and 19 meters. On May 26, 2017, amateur astronomer Sauveur Pedranghelu observed another flash from France. The event was announced the next day and was quickly confirmed by two German observers. The impactor had an estimated size of 4 to 10 meters. In practice, after the impressive cometary collision of 1994, 7 more impacts were recorded over 27 years, which forced astronomers to revise their estimates. In a study published in 1998, Nakamura and Kurashi estimated that a comet with a diameter greater than 1 kilometer could impact Jupiter every 500 to 1,000 years, but obviously these statistics were revised in the light of the Shoemaker-Levy 9 event, estimating between 50 and 350 years for an object of 0.5 to 1 kilometer. The estimates fell even more after the impact of 2009, when for an object of 0.5 to 1 kilometer it was assumed to be a frequency of 10 years, and 1 year for a meteoroid of about 10 meters in diameter. And obviously, they are further lowering in this period, after the two flashes of 2010. In the end, it is understood that to get reasonably reliable data on the real rate of impact of meteoroids and comets on Jupiter, it will be necessary to monitor the planet constantly, and in this type of research, it could be the amateurs to do the lion's share. After all, it is clear that the increase of the findings in recent years is not due to a random and abnormal increase of impacts, but to the increasing number of amateurs engaged in planetary observation and the increasing availability of astronomical instrumentation of absolute excellence. The light emission that accompanies the entry of a meteoroid into the Jovian atmosphere lasts very few seconds, 1 to 2 seconds, and is therefore necessary for continuous monitoring of the planet's surface and high frequency for their detection. Professional astronomers agree that telescopes with a diameter between 15 and 20 centimeters are the ideal tools for their detection if equipped with webcams or other video recording tools. So what are we waiting for? Let's all go out and observe Jupiter.